There's a lot of talk about happiness. So we all want happiness, of course. Yes, we all want happiness. Happiness is great, but why would I want happiness if I could have joy? Happiness is based on our circumstances. It's controlled by our external circumstances. Joy is inside of us, and it's not touched. True joy is not touched by our external circumstances. So here's what I mean by that. So I think many of us have had the experience of, we get a new car, or it's a new car to us, and we get this car, we're so excited, it's such a great car, woo, 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 it's so much better than the car we had before. 1 year later, when there are a couple of door dings in that car, it's dirty, needs to be washed, needs to be waxed, need to be vacuumed, the payment is due, the service, it needs service, oh my gosh, wasn't planning on that, didn't budget for that, and all the insurance premiums are way higher than I thought they were going to be. Now the car that made me so happy can make me miserable, can just be putting pressure on me. So same thing with, you get a cute little apartment, or you buy your first house and you're all excited, woo, 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 and you get all moved in, get all your stuff all put away, or you know where the scissors are and everything, and it's all good and you're so happy. And then a year later, 2 years later, something's broken, something needs to be fixed, something needs to be painted, something's fallen apart, it's not exactly how you hoped it would be, you don't like the neighbor next door, can't do a darn thing about it. You know, and so now the thing that made us happy isn't making us happy anymore. That's what I'm talking about. When you have joy inside of you, it doesn't matter what's broken, what needs to be fixed, what needs to be paid for that you don't have money for, you can be sad. You can have the coronavirus. You can have lost someone you love. And yet you can still have joy. And I am aware of completely how goofy that sounds. My husband has pointed out to me, do you know how you sound? I do, sorry, because when you have the joy inside of you, you literally can do what it says in the Bible. I think it's in Proverbs 31, the woman who laughs without fear of the future. Because fear is based in the future. What if this could happen? What if that happens? Oh no, I was mistreated for the first 16 years of my life. I've been lied to, I've been betrayed. I've had people in business cheat me in business dealings. All of my money was invested in a company that was located in World Trade 2 on 9/11, and I lost it. I mean, bad things can happen. And here's when it gets really goofy. When you can smile while you're crying over the circumstances, when you can still be like, oh crud, this is awful. Oh, well, you know what? One way or another, I'm going to get through. I know I am. When you can do that, then you have real joy. So let me tell you, here's the only way I know how to get real joy, authentic joy, which is sustainable. It is not interfered with by external circumstances. It's Jesus.
Amen.
You might say, oh, I got an amen. Woo, woo. You might say, well, you know, that's all well and fine, but I've known a lot of Christians who were really miserable and they didn't have any joy. Okay. I've known those people too. I would say to you that every single one of us, every single human, not just every single Christian, we're all a work in progress. When we decide that we are going to accept that Jesus is the only Son of God, that he is our Savior, that we're going to give our lives to him and ask him to lead us directly into his perfect plans for our lives, it doesn't mean that all of a sudden God flips a switch and we become perfect. No. I mean, really, nothing could be further from the truth. We're still us. So I remember the day that I decided that I wanted to be a Christian, and I thought everything's going to be perfect now. Well, guess what? No, it's not. So if you know people who wear a cross around their neck and have a Jesus fish on their bumper, and they are miserable people, just know that it's not over yet. They haven't fully walked the path yet to get to the place where the joy kicks in. I've been a Christian now for years, and I can say for the first 40 years of my life, you couldn't tell by my foul mouth or my language that I was a Christian. There was a point in time where it hit me. I thought, oh, I don't think I'm doing this right. And I took my cross off. And I took the Jesus fish off the bumper of the car. And I said, I'm not going to put the cross back on until I am worthy of it. until I can conduct myself in such a way that I am a passable ambassador of the kingdom of God. And somewhere in that time period, the joy kicked in and it has never left me. So I was able to smile while my heart was broken when I lost my best friend of 40 years. I've been able to smile when I've been, in the ER. I've been able to smile when some really, really hard things have happened because the joy is inside of me. Jesus is inside of me. I really and truly can laugh without fear of the future. So if you want that, or find a pastor, find somebody, you also can right now, right here, repeat after me and say, Jesus, I take you. I want you in my life. I give my life to you to do something with it. I want your joy. And please walk me fully into your plans and purpose for my life. And it's just that simple. He's waiting. So all you have to do is just ask him, just invite him in, because he's a gentleman. He will not force his way into your life. You have free will. An arm will not come out of heaven and stop you from robbing a bank, from, you know, doing the wrong thing, saying the wrong thing. You have free will to do whatever you want. I hope that you'll use your free will to get your own slice of joy and to bring Jesus into your life. If you are somebody who just prayed that prayer, I do want to strongly encourage you, reach out to a pastor, reach out to a friend you know who wears a cross around their neck or has a Jesus fish on their bumper. Hopefully they're not driving their uncle's car. somebody who can talk to you about this and start to learn, because there's a whole world waiting for you that is so joyful, because Jesus himself said, I came that you should have eternal life and abundant life here and now. So it's not just about eternal life, although, you know, our time here is like a mist and then, you know, and then it's eternity and that's what really counts. But it's not just that. I mean, he added, it's that we should have an abundant life now. If I would have known how abundant God was going to make my life way back when, I probably would have done something to screw it up, frankly. It's really, really good. And his plan for you is really, really good. And join us, Jenny and I, for our weekday live stream broadcast for just some help and encouragement for getting through tough times.